and welcome to Buckman's Model Mania. Today, I'm going to be working on the second issue of the new Robocop from Fanhome build. It's actually D'Agostini, and it was released a couple of years ago. I've seen some videos out there, seen that videos are available, haven't watched any. So let me go ahead and open the book, and we'll talk about parts for a second, and then we'll pause while I get the parts out and go to work. So in this issue, we're going to be building the right foot. We've got the right foot, toe cap. I think that's the instep, the rear sole, just several parts for the foot. And I'm going to point out same thing I did on the last video, that we're starting the screws are a little bit odd. We have AM and CM, no BM. I believe that they're using screws that were labeled for earlier builds, like the Falcon, perhaps, or the DeLorean. And, you know, so really odd way they're labeling the screws. Let me go ahead and pause the recording here. I'll get the parts out, and we will start building. Okay, got all the parts laid out here. You know, and what I do is I take this, make this my map as to how to lay them out. I don't know why, I just do. So the first thing it says to do is to take this rod, and there's actually a spot on the side there, on one end there, that has a lip, hole on the other end. Take this rod, put it through, let's see, join the two heel support pieces, two G and H with one AM screw, then fit the support into the back of the foot. And I'm looking, I don't think there's any rhyme or reason to the smaller of the pieces. So I'm gonna go ahead and get a screw out, dip it in some oil, and we will get those two pieces joined. And again, anybody who's been watching for a while knows I dip it in oil because it's going into the metal and it makes it go in a little bit easier, since we are actually cutting threads almost lost apart. That would be bad. So let me get this in here. And I'm going to go ahead and tighten it down all the way so that it still turns a little bit. I don't know if that's going to matter or not. I do have to say, it still turns just a hair. I do have to say, it's a little bit bad, the paint job on here. You can see a little bit of swirls and stuff. So then you take it here, and two AM screws, it goes in here like this. There's a indentation there and there for the AM screws, which are going to go in here and here. So let me go ahead and get two more of the AM screws out, and we'll start getting that in place. That's actually all the AM screws. And I mentioned in the, actually I didn't mention in the last video, I did, but I lost that video, best laid plans of mice and men. Right now I am a little bit low because I have so many part works going on places to store screws. So right now I'm leaving the screws in the bags, and I'm just gonna put them in the box I'm storing these parts in. I can get more, but I'm almost done with the Iron Man, and so I'll be able to free up all this stuff from the Iron Man at that point. Get this other side tightened up. And so, might be a little bit tight. Let me see if it's support. Doesn't say whether it has to be free or not. I'm thinking it's gonna have to be able to move. It moves okay, so I'm gonna leave it like that. And so the next thing it says, insert the first friction block into the base. So the first friction block Here's the base that it goes into. Here's the first friction block. It's just going to sit down in there like that. And then there's a second one, a smaller one inside it. And then insert the ball socket. And what these friction blocks do is it makes it so it holds in place when you're after you've built it. And insert the ball joint, this ball facing downwards, fix the three elements in place with 4 cm screws and tighten the screws well as they will be bearing the weight of the figure. I actually believe he might be able to stand up on his own without a stand. Before I do this, there are four spots right there, four tabs that these screws or these posts will go into. And actually, as I was putting it in there, it was a little bit off because I thought it was going to be straight. It's a little bit kitty corner, so it's going to go in there like that. Need to put four screws in there. Let me go ahead and get the CM screws out while everything falls apart. Only four. Of course, I got two that are trying to escape. Let's see if I can get this back in place without everything flipping all over the place. Doesn't really show, actually it does. This is upside down. I've actually got this in here, right? This, it's showing the pictures that this is gonna be on the side that it is. If, I'm sure that if it was not right, it will, you'll be able to move it later on. Not even sure whether that's catching yet. Doesn't look like it. That does not appear to be catching. Matter of fact, I guaranteed it's not because it popped out. If you try it on a different spot, doesn't work on this one. I will pause the camera, put it together, and come back. Okay, that one started. Let me grab another one. Get it started. Get the third one started, and then when I've got the fourth one started, I will go ahead and tighten them all down. Okay, that one started. Unlike last time, this time it started pretty quickly. Okay, tighten these all down. I'm just going in reverse order of the way I started them. Matter of fact, probably want bigger screwdriver, more torque. Maybe. There we go. Only works if it drops in the cross point. Okay. Tight. Tight. And yeah, that is. Can still move it with quite a bit of effort. I'm gonna see if I can get him just a hair tighter. This is where you snap screws. You just go for that last little bit and then the screw snaps. So there's that. Tighten screws, they bear the weight of the figure, and let's go to the next page. So the next thing is to place the instep. So this is the instep under here. Yeah, let me see. I think this is going to be the instep. Yeah, that's the instep. Is that the instep? It looks like it should be, but it also looks kind of weird. But that is where the screw hole is. Under there, fix it with the CM screw. Just looking. That is concerning. F. Spring. Just looking real quick. Ah, okay. I didn't see where this spring went in, but it actually goes in for the toe. It was disconcerting thinking that they would give you that kind of a part and not give you a place to put it yet. Try this again. So the instep goes in there, screw goes in there like that. That's got to be right because it's the only way it fits in there. Screw goes into the hole right there, tab holds it. It shifts a little bit left and right, but not up and down. Next part to go on here is, okay, got a couple of pins sticking on here. They're gonna go like that. And then the spring is gonna go between this post and this post, which allows it to move, and you secure it with two CM screws. I'm gonna put it on the back first, because that's the stationary part of the spring. Got the oil on it, put the screw through the spring, tighten it down. And hopefully this is better than the spring was on the Ghostbuster car, because my hood no longer stays open. The spring came off because the tab broke off. Okay, so it's on there. It's a little bit off to the corner, off to the side. It'll be fine. I'm going to go ahead and start the screw on the center of the toe section. And then loop it across. Because it's open on that end. So I've got the screw started. It's way up. Pop this in here. And you can see, oh, there's a hook on the end of the spring. Take that hook. Pretty serious spring there. Let's try it a different way, because that did not want to go. Hook it over the screw and then move it across. Tighten it down to where it's going to actually hold that spring in place. Inside the foot, fit the spring, which allows it to move. Secure it with two CM screws. Interesting. Once the internal elements have been fitted, fit the rear sole. 2D, and you can see number of, let's see, 5 posts for screws. And it's actually got a spot right here where the spring goes through. Go ahead and get the five screws out. Pop that one in there. Actually, look at that. I grabbed five screws. Didn't count them when I first pulled them out. There's number three. Four. And five. Then I'm going to go back and tighten them all down. Okay. Starting from the back up to the front. That's got that. I'm just curious. Oh, I see. When he walks, this will flex. Kind of neat the way they did that. Let me put this last piece in here. By the way, all the pieces except for the two cap pieces, the three cap pieces underneath the ball here, everything on this stage is metal. Didn't mention that prior to this. Yeah, these packs of screws have got to be left over from something else because normally you have one spare screw. I've got three of the CM. I had two APs in the last pack. So dip this in oil. That is a very strong spring too, relatively speaking, for its size. Tighten that. Tighten that. So the foot is now done. Like I said, it's got some flex like a regular foot. So there's that. Just looking. That's the way the foot looks. Doesn't flex left and right anymore. And there's the helmet. So that is all I've got for today and for actually this month. This is the first two packs. This is the first shipment from Fanhome 4 Robocop. Kind of looking good. I like the way it is. There's a lot of metal in this build. Shiny plastic. Rest of this was metal except for the parts in here and the visor. All of this was metal except for the caps. Really looking pretty impressive. I'm happy with it so far. Looking forward to getting more. Unfortunately, it's going to be another month. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I can't say I'm enjoying this build yet so far. I'm enjoying what I've done, but there's a long ways to go before I really decide whether it's a really good build or not. So far, I like it. So, like, subscribe, comment. Come on over to Hobby Tom Modelers on Facebook, YouTube, and Discord. See what we're doing. Links should be in the description. Take care of yourselves. Take care of yourselves tomorrow. Have a great day. Take care of each other, and I will catch you on the next video.